Welcome to another installment of The Grid, your monthly video game news fix. If you're new to the show, where have you been? Now, the biggest news on the gaming horizon is the buzz about next-gen consoles. We've been talking a lot about them in past episodes, but there's so much more on the horizon. Now, on May 21st, Microsoft will hold the event we've all been waiting for to announce their next-gen console. Early rumors called it the Xbox 720, but a new logo may instead reveal a less numeric name, Xbox Infinity. Now, it's just a rumor, of course, just like the whole thing about two versions of the console, and that'll be released in November for $500, but we'll know a lot more after the event. Now, another event planned by Microsoft is the one on June 10th for E3. The convention planning is in full swing, and there are two notable absences from the roster. 2K Games and Valve will not be showcasing at this event. At this point, we can only speculate what that means, but in the meantime, we'll just look forward to the annual electronics show. It starts June 11th. Now, speaking of Microsoft, the company currently has an opening after game director Adam Orth spouted off and insulted fans on the company's Twitter feed. It was involving the rumor of the always-on internet connection needed for the Xbox 720. He has resigned his position and apologized in light of the recent events. No news yet as to who will be filling his now vacant position. Now back to next-gen console news. Sony has officially released details and a video about their newest DualShock controller. The touchpad and the share button appear to be the biggest changes, but you can check out the video by following the link on your screen. Now, speaking of Sony, the company filed a patent back in August 2011, whose details are just now coming to light. NeoGAF initially spotted the interesting bits of the patent, one about a load time system, specifically a system and method for detecting piracy of a software product. First, David Hayter, now Kevin Conroy, the voice actor, has confirmed he will not be returning as the voice of Batman in Arkham Origins. Mark Hamill had also previously confirmed he won't be a part of the game. Now, the game will chronicle the early years of the Arkham series. The game may even include multiplayer, rumor of course, and these lovely new images have come out in the recent issue of Game Informer. Another exciting feature of the game, the new dynamic weather system. More details to come, of course, and the game is set to release on the Xbox 360, PS3, PC, and Wii U on October 25th. Now, Bethesda has confirmed the upcoming release of the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Legendary Edition. The Legendary Edition will include the game, all official downloadable content, and an added legendary difficulty mode. The newest edition of the hit game will drop on June 4th in the US and June 7th in Europe and Australia, and will be available for the Xbox 360, PS3, and PC. Now, Bethesda has been very busy between the Elder Scrolls Online franchise, their whole newest announced game, The Evil Within. It's a survival horror game from Shinji Mikami. Most folks know him as the creator of the Resident Evil games. And it's slated for release in 2014. You can check out the official announcement trailer by following the link. More details are emerging about the multiplayer content of Lost Planet 3. There will be a scenario mode and acrid survival mode featuring different challenges. The game is set for release on August 27th for the Xbox 360, PS3, and PC. A team at the Netherlands-based Leiden University published a research paper that says video games, specifically first-person shooters, enhance the memory capacity of players. The study was published in the journal Psychological Research and puts forth the theory that video games enhance working memory capacity by training the brain to become more flexible. Now, like any scientific study, you always have to look at the hard data, but it raises the possibility that video games might actually have a little bit more benefit to them other than their whole stress relief quality. Now, another theory is that video games make you feel good. Tobias Battens developed a theory that video games are going to be bigger than movies in the 21st century. The interactive nature of video games, according to Batten, will lead to the medium becoming a dominant entertainment medium. His variable dopamine wavelength mapping theory incorporates both Pavlov and Maslow in creating a psychological system of risk and reward that ultimately leads to the success of a game because players want to keep plane and get to the next dopamine rush. Mars has been in the news lately. We even had a couple stories on the latest week in review. Now, Mars Wars Logs has launched on Steam with Xbox and PlayStation versions coming soon. Class warfare in the middle of the Mars colony, along with sci-fi action and varied character interaction. It's rated M, and you can see the trailer by following the link. While many games have found their way off the ground, some through the crowdfunding site Kickstarter, I'm sad to announce that the Kickstarter project for the sequel of the Sega Genesis game, Echo the Dolphin, a project named The Big Blue, made a mere 55,700 of their 665,000 goal. Creator Ed Annunziata has now resorted to Plan B. The Little Blue project hasn't kicked off yet, but we'll be sure to let you know just in case you're interested. Now, Kickstarter's usual model is to offer up incentives for the project prior to the project's finish. Seems Blizzard's been taking note. Diablo 3 for the PS3 doesn't have a release date, nor any really definite details about the changes between the PC and the console version, but now players will have a special item for an XP boost. Well, only if you pre-order. The Infernal Helm looks fairly nifty, but frankly, I'm not going to be buying the game. How about you all? Planning on spending your money on another Blizzard franchise? Tell us in the comments. Now, lastly, we leave you with a bit of sad news. As of April 22nd, G4 is now officially part of the Esquire network. Most of their shows have aired their last, and an era has truthfully ended. You can, of course, continue to get your news, though, here on The Grid, or over on our main site, sci-fi4me.com. You can check out The Grid the first Wednesday of every month here on our YouTube channel. And you can be the first to know when we post videos when you subscribe. Also, you can connect with us on Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest. Be sure to share us with your friends and tell us your thoughts on the news in the comments below. We'll see you back here next month on June 5th.